What's up, everyone? Mr. Julio here, your OST High School Facilitator, and today we're going to learn how to cook chicken fajitas.
And remember, before we get into what we're doing today, we're going to take 3 minutes out of our day to just cool down and relax. Let's just clear our minds and remove all the distractions from our everyday life. Being quarantined, staying in the house can be really harsh on our mental, you know? So let's take 3 minutes to clear our mind, relax, put your do not disturb on your phone, listen to this relaxing music, some lo-fi, before we get into our lesson. So for the chicken fajitas, we're going to need some boneless chicken. Rather, if you use chicken breasts or chicken thighs, it don't matter. We're going to need some peppers and onions. So that's green peppers, red peppers, yellow peppers, and onions. You can get them fresh and cut them yourself, or you can get the frozen bag. It really doesn't matter. Then we're going to need seasoning. So we got garlic, we got sazon, salt, adobo, some sofrito, and we're going to need some tomato sauce.
We gon' be a hype.
So after you're done washing your hands, the first thing you're going to want to do is cut up your chicken. So you're going to get a knife. Be careful while you're cutting up your chicken. Basically, you're going to get the knife in the other hand. And with this hand, kind of go like that to where it's going against, not your fingers, but the right below the knuckles. So you don't cut yourself. Make it as straight as possible while you're cutting your chicken. So, if you guys want to be a little bit fancy and learn like the proper ways to cut and trim a chicken breast, you can watch this video right after this.
Wash and dry the chicken and lay it flat on a cutting board. With a sharp knife, cut down the middle of the breast along one side of the cartilage. Trim the centerpiece off the remaining half. If you'd like, remove the cutlet on the bottom of each half. Continue to trim the fat around the edge of the chicken breast. Depending on your recipe, you can slice the chicken at a slight angle, or you can slice, turn, and dice to create cubes. Alternatively, cover the chicken with plastic wrap and pound it with a mallet or small frying pan. This will flatten the chicken, ensuring even cooking all the way through.
And after you cut your chicken long ways like this, you're just gonna get it one little slice down the middle. That's it. To every single piece that you cut up. So after you cut up all your chicken, you're going to want to put it inside of a bowl or a big pot so you could season it. Now, as you see, I have a lot of chicken here because I have a lot of people to feed. So basically, you're going to have enough chicken based off of how many people it's eating. Also, with your seasoning, I don't season to a measurement. I season by sight. So based on how many people you have, and how much chicken you have, is going to be how much seasoning you put in. Also, based off of preference. If you like more seasoned chicken, then you're going to put more seasoning. If your family does not, then you're not.
It is what it is.
It is what it is.
I'm in love with adobo. I'm in love with adobo.
Flito.
I'm in love with adobo. I'm in love with adobo. I put it on my pollo. I'm in love with adobo. I'm in love with adobo. I'm in love with adobo. I put it on my pollo. I'm in love with adobo.
Sazón, y'all. Not that much garlic, just a little bit. Salt. Now this is a preference as well, because adobo and sazon also have salt, so not a lot of salt in my preference, because the other things have salt, and yeah. So the first sazon we used was a tropical sazon. The next sazon I'm going to use is the red sazon, because you know there's like an old Spanish saying that says if your chicken ain't orange, it ain't seasoned right. Also, you're going to want to put a little bit of sofrito in with your chicken that you're going to mix around and season. Not a lot, because we're also going to put some sofrito in the pan. So not a lot.
And this right here is another preference. It's just a little bit of a hot sauce. Like I said, preference. Don't have to do it. It's on you. You like it spicy? Hot sauce it up. Now this is when your hand's gonna get dirty, because I mean, you ain't seasoning no chicken right unless you get your hands up in the chicken and you massage that seasoning in there. Now, some people go look at this video and be like, that's nasty. Nope, because our hands are washed, correct? Of course, because we gonna be alright. We wash our hands. So, make sure you wash your hands again if your hands are dirty before you season your chicken. Then you're gonna get your hands in there, you're gonna mix the seasoning around with your hands. Massage it into the chicken. After your chicken is mixed and you've washed your hands, here goes another preference. Go get some cilantro that you chopped up, put it right inside there. That's nasty. Not really, because our hands are washed. But yeah, put some cilantro in there. And then also, another preference, you take some lemon or lime and just squeeze it in there. Just squeeze it in there. Get that lime juice. You could also use lemons. Really doesn't matter. After you're done with the lime juice, you're going to mix it all up again. Wash your hands again, and then we're going to start cooking. So before we start cooking in the pan, we're going to, well, me, preferably, the limes that I used, I squeeze them and toss them in the pan. Because before I start cooking my chicken, I'm going to put more of sazon in there. Then I'm going to put some sofrito in there. About that much. That's like 3 spoonfuls, but these are a little spoon. So 3 baby spoonfuls, or about like 1.5, 2 spoonfuls of regular spoon. I'm going to add some tomato sauce. Then we go turn it on and we go mix it up. So just put it all around this pan. All around this pan. Also, you can add some butter to this. It would make your chicken more buttery. Or you could add some oil. I'm gonna add olive oil to this. So just put a little bit of olive oil as it kind of just gets the aroma of everything that we put in there. And then we add the chicken to cook inside of it. So as it's heating up a bit, you're going to want to constantly move everything around. You see it bubbling a little bit. When it starts to bubble, though, we're going to add our peppers and onions. After we mixed it up, we added our peppers and onions. Another preference, it depends on you. If you like spice, you can add some jalapeno slices. Just when you add them, cut them in half as well. Cut them into little bits. Put them in the mix. And then you'll mix it around and make this little circle in the middle for our chicken. So, we're going to put some of our chicken in. Then, as you can see, I kind of put it everywhere. You're going to mix it up a little bit. So, it gets mixed up with everything you have here. And then, we're going to let it cook. As you notice, when your chicken starts cooking a little bit, or you see some steam, I'm going to say, depends on how much chicken you put in. It could be, like, in the 2 minutes, in 3 minutes, 5 minutes. Depends on chicken. So, with this amount of chicken, in about 3 to 5 minutes, I'm going to want to mix it around again as the chicken starts to cook on one side, so it can cook on the other side. So something you could do to help your chicken fajitas cook is to get one of these. Put it right on top of your pan. Simple as that. All the heat and all this, all the heat and all the steam is kind of going to stay in there, so it's going to help it cook. Also, get a spatula or a spoon. Don't keep using a little spoon, because we're going to get into some serious chicken work. Oh, it smells so good. So we're going to flip it now. Now, when it's all said and done, your chicken should look like this. All orange, there's peppers and onions in there. There's some jalapenos in there. Now, you could put this in a tortilla. You could put it over white rice. You could put it with mashed potatoes. You could really put it with anything. It's just chicken, peppers, and onions. Some jalapenos. That's chicken fajitas. You could put it with beans. You could put whatever you like. So yeah, if you do a tortilla, you just put a little bit inside of your tortilla, wrap it up, and it's good to eat.
So if you want to cook some rice with your chicken fajitas, like I mentioned before, I did not cook any rice, but you could always put the chicken fajitas over rice. So we could watch this video by Tasty on how to cook rice.
Rice is such a staple ingredient, and yet so many people fear it. So many people say, I don't know how to make it, it gets too sticky, it gets burnt. How do you make the perfect rice? We're here to tell you. There's a few really simple tips and tricks to get that perfect, fluffy, great consistency. The two most important things to keep in mind when making rice are timing and ratios. If you cook it too short, it can be hard, and if you cook it for too long, it can just be gummy and mushy. No one wants that. In regards to ratios, if you have too much water, you can just have really wet rice. And if you don't have enough, you can burn your rice. For long grain white rice, you want 1 cup of rice to 2 cups of water. For short grain white rice, you want 1 cup of rice to 1 1/4 cups water. For brown rice, you want 1 cup of rice to 1 3/4 cups water. For whatever type of rice you're making, you're gonna follow a similar process. One tip to help you make the best rice ever is to rinse your rice before cooking it. Rinsing rice helps remove any extra starch. If you're short on time, you can skip this step, but it's a foolproof way to help you get really fluffy, beautiful rice. Some people rinse the rice until the water runs clear. A good method to go by is just rinsing it 3 times. First, I'm going to add the rice and the water and a pinch of salt, totally optional, but it'll give it some extra flavor, and bring it to a boil over high heat. Once the water begins to boil, give it a stir, put the lid on, and turn the heat down to simmer, which is the lowest heat there is. For long grain white rice, you want to cook it for 18 minutes on simmer. For short grain white rice, you want to simmer it for 15 minutes. Brown rice is a bit longer, you want to simmer it for 45 minutes. One really important thing to note is to not remove the lid as you're cooking it. You're steaming the rice and you don't want to let the hot air escape. Just let it be, trust the timing, and it'll come out perfectly. Pro tip, once you remove the pot from the heat, let it steam for an additional 5 to 10 minutes with the lid on, and that's another way to ensure you get really fluffy, beautifully cooked rice. Again, if you're short on time, you can skip this step, but we're trying to get you the best rice possible. It's worth the extra 5 to 10 minutes to get really fluffy rice. Long grain white rice is perhaps the most common rice, at least in America. You can use it for side dishes, pilafs, salads, or just on its own with a protein. Short grain white rice is typically used for sushi, puddings, paella, risotto, and sticky rice. Brown rice is considered to be a healthier option than white rice. It has more fiber, iron, and vitamin B. So white rice is actually brown rice with the bran and germ stripped away, so you're losing some of those nutrients when you're choosing white rice. And while it does take longer to make, it's a bit earthier, nuttier. If you do it correctly, you can actually get a really nice result. Now that you know how to make a really simple pot of rice, we're gonna show you how to upgrade it with a few super simple tips and tricks. So first, add olive oil over high heat in the pan. Next up, add shallots, or you can swap this out with any other allium. You could use onions, scallions, garlic, anything that's gonna give it a bit of flavor. Cook the shallots for 30 seconds to a minute until it's aromatic and golden brown. Then add the rice, give that a stir to make sure that it's fully coated with the shallots and the olive oil. You only need to do this for about 30 seconds, so right now you're just toasting the rice. That's a really easy way to add some extra nutty flavor. Then add a splash of white wine. This is totally optional. The alcohol burns off, and it's just a really nice way, again, to add flavor. You can also swap water for stock. Vegetable stock, chicken, beef, whatever you want to use. And again, a pinch of salt will go a long way. So from here, the process is the same. You'll get a really flavorful result without spending too much extra time. The thing is, you can mix and match with what you want to add to upgrade your rice. It's a really easy way to trick your friends into thinking you're extra fancy. It's true, they're gonna love it. If you're someone who makes rice all the time, it might be worth investing in a rice cooker. Rice cookers are super easy to use, they're less fussy, everything's marked out for you in terms of proportions. It's a foolproof way of getting a consistently perfect batch of rice every time. The first steps to becoming a better cook are mastering the basics. Rice is such a staple dish, and if you can master it, it'll just make you a better cook. It really doesn't have to be scary, and it doesn't have to be boring either. If you just pay attention to timing and ratios and add a few flavor boosters, you can have the best rice ever.